Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 3 Blind. I'm the RPG chick. Leaving the Citadel now, back to Normandy. Yesh. This is not the Normandy. Unless we have a holodeck equipped now. It's intro, kid. Intro, kid! Oh, I can only walk very slowly, and run does not change anything. No map. I must be dreaming. Intro, kid! Don't get on the ship! The shuttlecraft! Don't do it! Oh! Get back here, intro kid! I can't run like that for some stupid reason, and I can't go through that. No! I have no idea where you are. Oh, there you are. It's a good thing you shine like a beacon, so I can find you. Falling leaves like at the Citadel. Take my hand. Oh my god. Yep, swiftly becoming nightmare. Yeah, that sucked. You fell asleep with full makeup on, too. And we look perfectly awesome.
Liara.
Which is good, because Liara's
here.
You?
I've been forwarding the Turian Counselor information on the Prothean device. It can't be built without Council support, but he's not budging until their Primarch is safe.
Hmm.
I know.
Yeah.
Are you all right?
I've been better.
I didn't get what you'd call a good night's rest. There's more to it than that, isn't there? What's really bothering you?
We're sleeping in separate rooms. Now everyone... Everyone back on Earth.
When the Reapers hit, I could hear people screaming in the streets below me. We left a lot of them behind. There's no way for you to save them all. But I know you're doing everything you can, and you'll get back there in time to help. I hope you're right. Don't blame yourself, Commander. Commander Shepard, I'm Specialist... Oh. I beg your pardon. I thought you were alone.
Hmm.
I was just leaving.
She's not invisible, you know.
Commander Shepard... I'm Comm Specialist Samantha Trainer with Alliance R&D. I was part of the team retrofitting the Normandy after you turned it over to the Alliance.
Oh. Cool.
There weren't many of us aboard when the Reapers hit.
It's okay.
Slow down, Specialist Trainer. You're doing fine.
Thank you. I worked in a lab. I never thought I'd be serving on a ship.
Why don't you tell me about the retrofits?
The ship's in line with Alliance regs now, and it has new, top-of-the-line, quantum entanglement communicators. In fact, Admiral Anderson had intended to use the Normandy as his mobile command center.
That's no longer an option.
Yes, I heard he chose to stay and fight. In any event, I'm honored to serve under you, Commander. For as long as you need me, that is. They only sent me here to oversee the retrofits.
Oh god, relax.
Some of our systems require further testing, and Specialist Trainer has been extremely effective during installation. I would prefer that she remain.
Yeah,
got
she
it, Edie.
She can remain.
Since when does a virtual intelligence make requests?
Edie's an AI. Fully self-aware.
Oh, I knew it. I knew Joker was lying.
He told you?
Jennifer requested that I pretend to be a simple VI to protect myself.
Huh.
I apologize for the deception.
To protect
Thanks,
herself.
Edie, and I apologize for all those times I talked about how attractive your voice was.
What?
Anyway, shall I give you a tour? I think you'll be impressed by the new upgrades. In the CIC, you'll find the galaxy map where you can set the Normandy's destination.
Yes, yes, it's not new.
You can also check your messages at your private terminal.
That's not new either.
The war room houses a strategic command center for mission-specific intel and war analysis.
That's new.
The shuttle bay contains an armory where you can modify your equipment between missions.
Okay, good. I was
Finally, Liara has set up a lot of hardware down in the old XO office on Deck 3. I think she's claimed that room. And there you are. Still the same ship as before, it just flies Alliance colors now. Speaking of which, I believe Admiral Hackett would like to speak to you at the Vid Comm.
Busy, busy, busy. You know, I just woke up. I haven't brushed my teeth. I didn't have breakfast.
Commander. Udina updated me on your meeting with the Council. Sounds like they're running scared.
Forgive me, sir, but you look like hell. I do understand their concerns, though.
We did present them with a lot of unknowns. They're feeling threatened and want immediate solutions, not theories.
Theories are all we've got right now. What's your plan?
I'm trying to get the Turian Primarch for a summit meeting with the Asari and Salarians. I'll bypass the Council and appeal directly to their leadership.
That's good. I like it. This is where we start laying the groundwork for our counterattack.
Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, we don't have a whole lot to back it up right now.
Then build alliances. Gather everything and everybody you can for the cause.
Roger that.
What about the Prothean device?
Find me people who can help build it, and if you can't, I'll take ships, soldiers, supplies, whatever you can get. We need to keep hitting the Reapers across every theater of war they open. Buy us time to figure out the device.
And when it's finished?
Assuming it ever is, we pool all our resources.
Right.
Think of it as a giant armada for delivering the device when the Reapers are most vulnerable.
When would that
be? The stronger you can make that armada, the better the chances of punching through.
Okay, got it. And what about Earth?
What about Earth, sir?
We'll just have to hope Anderson and what's left of the Alliance forces can hold out until we've dealt with the enemy.
I understand.
Good. Then make it happen, Commander. I'll be expecting regular updates on your progress. Hack it out.
Intel armor mod kit. Okay, modify armor as well. Right, so this is where the holograms appear. So we have like one like that in the Spectre room on the Citadel. I expect we'll be going back to that Spectre room. Now and again, at least. Joker! Okay, so Specialist Trainer is hanging out by the galaxy map. Is she our new Kelly, then? We're in the war room, Vid Comm there. Liara is here. Main battery, right, AI core, medical, mess hall, same basic layout here. Of course, starboard, lounge, crew quarters. So this is a lounge now? Engineer Adams. Right. Engineer Adams. We didn't have an Engineer Adams in the second game, did we? But I do remember him. Subdeck stairwell. Diana Allers is here. I guess she's considered cargo. Port cargo. Shuttle bay, where lurks James and Lieutenant Cortez. Whoever the hell that is. And my cabin with my fish tank, armor locker, and my personal terminal. want to head back to my cabin. The people, weapons, armies, and fleets that you've accumulated are your war assets. The overall readiness of the galaxy determines how effectively these assets will perform in the final battle. Alright, so we gotta catch them all, I guess. Now, what's her name in the cargo hold is considered an asset. The Systems Alliance represents humanity's economic, political, and military reach throughout the galaxy. Its naval forces are led by Admiral Stephen Hackett. Oh my, all this. So these are our current assets then, I'm guessing. So the Alliance is at 745. The Alliance Engineering Corps cuts roads through mountains and builds bases on asteroids. While the bulk of the AEC has active wartime duties, their brightest are helping build a device of Prothean origin recovered on Mars. Due to the staggering amount of raw materials required, the AEC has been given unprecedented emergency funding for any Alliance resources that will not interfere with the deployment of troops. 103rd Marine Division. The old saying, every Marine is a rifleman, still holds true in the Alliance. Every Marine enlistee, from clerk to sniper, goes to a period of infantry training. As a result, the 103rd Marine Division is Earth's largest collection of Special Forces soldiers. Officers from notable battles, such as the Skillian Blitz and the First Contact War, run harsh training exercises in a variety of environments, insisting the Marines be prepared to storm any beach on any planet. This training has been useful in the Reaper War, as the 103rd can be fighting an Arctic desert 1 week, crawling through jungles the next. Admiral Mikhailovich. Whoops. When the Reaper called Sovereign attacked the Citadel in 2183, Rear Admiral Boris Mikhailovich led the 63rd Scout Flotilla against it. The 63rd suffered the fewest losses of any Alliance flotilla during the Battle of the Citadel, while providing crucial support for the 5th Fleet's carriers and dreadnoughts. The Alliance promoted Mikhailovich from Rear Admiral to Admiral after the battle, and has tasked him with rebuilding and upgrading his ships. His combat experience with the Reapers has been invaluable in devising strategies against them. Alliance First Fleet. The First Fleet was stationed near the Charon Relay when the Reapers invaded the Sol system. Oh, wow. By the time Admiral Hackett issued the order to retreat... Now, did they come through the mass relay? The Reapers? Or on their own power. By the time Admiral Hackett issued the order to retreat, its size, once the largest in the Alliance Navy, had been cut in half. Commanding Admiral Inez Lindholm made the painful decision to use a tenth of the fleet's remaining vessels as cover so the remainder could escape. Damn, that's gonna be hard. Decision to make. Her gamble paid off as the First Fleet limped out of the relay to rally with the rest of the Alliance forces on the run. Alliance Third Fleet. Stationed at Arcturus, the Third Fleet is headed by Admiral Nitesh Singh. When the Reapers came for the station, Singh had already pulled his command ship, the SSV Logan, back to an ideal firing position for its mass accelerator cannons. The Dreadnought's guns managed to slow down a destroyer before it could demolish the Third Fleet, but Singh was forced to retreat in the face of overwhelming opposition from the Reapers. We have four more. Alliance 5th Fleet. The 5th Fleet became famous across the galaxy after spearheading Alliance forces at the Battle of the Citadel. It was guarding Arcturus Station when the Reapers attacked. After a bloody and desperate battle, Admiral Hackett gave the order to retreat, sacrificing the entirety of the Alliance 2nd Fleet to give the 3rd and 5th the chance to escape. The 5th Fleet's engineers are busy repairing its damaged vessels, grimly anticipating return to Earth and revenge against the Reapers. And we just secure this one, Diana Allers. Still wearing that bathing suit. Alliance News Network reporter Diana Allers has been broadcasting from the Normandy, interviewing crew members and high-ranking Alliance officers to give the galaxy an insider's view of the war. Now I wonder how she qualifies as a war asset. For morale? I don't even know. Maybe we can use her in the future to, you know, I don't know, communicate with people. I don't know. Alliance frigate Normandy SR-2. Well, never heard of it. When the original SSV Normandy was destroyed, Cerberus rebuilt the ship from stolen Alliance plans. Dubbed the SR-2, the Alliance took the new Normandy apart and refitted some of its systems with new technology of its own. As a result, the SR-2 Normandy is the highest performing frigate in the entire Alliance Navy and possibly the fastest ship in its class. Oh wow, I got a lot. The Normandy is commanded by Shepard, an Alliance officer and humanity's first Spectre. Updated. To bolster the Normandy's firepower, Commander Shepard installed a Thanix magnetic hydrodynamic cannon on the ship's undercarriage. Based on Reaper technology, the powerful weapon fires molten metal accelerated to a fraction of the speed of light. So I guess these are the upgrades we did in the, you know, Mass Effect 2. Because that does sound familiar. Before taking on the Collectors, Commander Shepard reinforced the Normandy's superstructure with Solaris armor. Yeah, I'm sure now. This protective layer of carbon nanotube sheeting can withstand temperatures that would instantly vaporize more conventional armor. And updated, the Normandy has been upgraded with cyclonic barrier technology. I'm pretty sure that was the last one I put on. Allowing the ship's mass effect field projectors to fire rapidly oscillating barriers that deflect rather than directly absorb kinetic shocks. Now I wonder if me upgrading this stuff has made this number higher than it, you know, otherwise would be. Mineral resources. Commander Shepard uncovered significant elemental deposits while scanning planets with the Normandy SR-2. Oh, all the stuff I got? When the Alliance dry docked the Normandy, they seized all recovered elements. This material surplus has gone towards building the Prothean device discovered on Mars. Good. So actually the stuff that I did in the previous game actually helps now. That's pretty cool. So yeah, I had over 100k with everything, including, it's on the tip of my tongue. Palladium, platinum, the other one, and, Element Zero. Element Zero is the one that was really hard to find. So that's what puts us at 50%. Wonder what you start out with otherwise. So we have War Map. Theaters of War. Each conflict zone has a readiness rating that reflects its ability to contribute to the final battle. Left unattended, these zones can deteriorate and reduce the overall readiness rating. Okay, so we gotta look at this, I guess, periodically or often. And this might be a little more important than the fish in our quarters. Okay, so Inner Council Space here. This territory includes the Solarian, Turian, Volus, and Hanar homeworlds, as well as the Citadel, the heart of Council Space. The Citadel receives a constant influx of diplomats, military officials, major corporate shareholders, and others who seek to do business at the seat of a galactic governance. Council races provide peacekeeping ships that patrol Inner Council Space, but they use diplomacy or other peaceful means to settle most disputes in this area of the galaxy. Terminus Systems. The Terminus Systems are an area of space uncontrolled by the Citadel. A refusal to relinquish independence is all that unites its numerous colonies, gangs, and factions. People of all species flock here to make their fortune outside the Council's regulations. As a result, the Terminus Systems are a profitable haven for pirates, mercenary groups, and slavers. Earth Systems Alliance Space. The Systems Alliance, the representative of Earth and all human colonies in Citadel Space, claims these territories. Earth has increased its holdings more than tenfold since the discovery of the Charon Relay linked humanity to the rest of the galaxy. Humanity's aggressive expansionism has triggered conflicts with several neighboring species and their governments, most notably the Batarian hegemony. Despite this, the Systems Alliance shows no signs of slowing its growth. Outer Council Space. Outer Council Space contains the Asari and Elcor's home planets. While the Elcor content themselves with their home system and a handful of colonies, the Asari have settlements across the territory. Easily the most economically powerful sector of the galaxy, the Asari worlds use their financial clout to keep the galactic market stable. Their military fleets patrol shipping lanes and colony space against smugglers arriving via relays from the Attican Traverse. Speaking of which, the Attican Traverse. The Attican Traverse is a large territory on the edge of civilized quote-unquote space. Connected by an extensive collection of relays, its colonies are often raided by the neighboring terminus systems. As habitable planets in the galaxy are scarce, the colonies persevere despite these attacks. The Attican Traverse is littered with Prothean ruins, which attract archaeological expeditions determined to unlock the secrets of this advanced technology. So now we've only got the Alliance and various assets thereof. More information? Your total military strength is now 745. Galactic readiness is sitting at 50%. Allied forces are overwhelmed by Reapers on multiple fronts and taking heavy casualties. Troops assisting in a final push will have a strength of 372. Chances of success are very poor. Well, we're gonna have to fix that, aren't we? The War Room. Which again makes me think of Babylon 5. As the war with the Shadow started in earnest, they decided to make a war room. You don't see it very often in the series, but it was a pretty neat thing to observe. Tech labs are this way. Right, really the only way you can go. So I'm guessing this is not the bathroom, but rather the elevator, as I had guessed before. Can we go down there? Scary down there. Oh, nothing in here to look at. At least right now, right? This actually makes me think of, well, there's no chairs here, but makes me think of the conference room on Star Trek The Next Generation. Thought I wasn't going to get through that.
Commander, the Alliance has found a new Cerberus lab on Sanctum.
Oh, Commander.
Hackett would like you to investigate. Commander, come to check on your new recruit.
Just wanted to see how you were doing.
Still trying to get my bearings. When I was working on the Normandy's upgrades, I left at the end of the day. I didn't even have a toothbrush or a change of clothing until I made some emergency purchases on the Citadel.
Where's, Kelly? Kelly Chambers, is it, I believe? I could have helped you.
Next time you need something, just ask. You're not alone here.
Oh, it's no trouble, Commander. I'm sure you have larger concerns.
We can put in a requisition order.
My toothbrush is a Scission Promark 4. It uses tiny mass effect fields to break up plaque and massage the gums. It costs 6,000 credits.
Oh, God.
Okay. Yeah. You're on your own with that.
In any event, I appreciate you giving me the chance to stay. Was there anything else?
What will they think of next? A toothbrush that uses mass effect fields. Oh my god. Tell me about your personal history.
Where are you from originally?
A colony in the terminal
Sounds
systems,
better.
Actually. Though I studied on Earth, at Oxford. My parents were from London. They loved Earth, but they wanted the freedom a colony life could offer. If they stayed in London, I imagine they'd be dead right now.
Don't talk like that. We gotta have hope.
A lot of people back on Earth are still alive and counting on us.
Quite true, Commander.
Your lab job.
You worked in Alliance R&D?
Yes. You'd think quantum entanglement would make communication easy, but imagine incorporating multiple incoming sources and then networking them with extrapolations of time lag data to construct a coherent situation GUI. It's an exciting challenge. For me, anyway.
Yeah, you go with your bad self there. And you join the military.
I do end up in the military anyway.
My family didn't have money for university. When the Alliance saw my aptitude scores, they offered me a full scholarship. I served my required years after graduation and decided to stay. I really like the challenges of the lab. Although, I'm sure I'll grow to love frontline service as well.
You really have to relax. Reaction to the war?
I'm surprised you're worrying about a toothbrush. We got bigger problems right now.
Oop.
Oh, believe me. Seeing the Reapers on Earth was terrifying.
That was gonna freak her out there.
By bursting into tears here in the CIC, will I? Being here on the Normandy helps. If anyone in the galaxy can stop the Reapers, it's you. And if flagging your messages and managing strategic intel helps you in any way, then it's worth it.
It might. But thanks for the vote of confidence.
Carry on, Specialist.
Well, Edie's not hanging out over here like she used to. Alright, what about my private terminal? We've got email and this. Review how to use powers effectively.
For increased tactical control, bring up the power menu.
Yeah.
This pauses the action, giving you time to evaluate the battlefield, target new enemies, and select a power. To use a power to attack an opponent, target the enemy before pausing the game, then highlight and select the power. The power will fire at the targeted enemy as you return to action. For maximum tactical effectiveness, use squadmate powers in combination with your own, hitting enemies with up to 3 powers at once.
Works pretty well. Basic power use. Advanced power use. Maybe they'll tell me something here that I don't already know.
After using a power, you must wait for it to recharge before using it again. This is called the cooldown period. When a power is in cooldown, its icon is gray. A red icon indicates that the power cannot affect the current target.
Or at least minimally.
Some offensive powers are guided and can be aimed to hit enemies over cover and around corners. There are other useful tools on the power menu. To use powers in real time, drag and drop them to quickfire keys in the power menu. If you have enough metagel, select First Aid to revive a squadmate and to recover a portion of Shepard's health. You can also activate ammunition powers, like cryo ammo and incendiary ammo, to upgrade your weapon.
Nope, nothing I don't already know. Review how to issue orders to squadmates like position and targeting.
Issue orders to your squadmates by using the following keystrokes.
Q and E.
Press Q or E to order a squadmate to attack, move to cover, or take a position. To order a squadmate to attack with a power, press Q or E while targeting an enemy. Z issues an order to both squad mates to open fire on the targeted enemy.
That went boom.
And pressing C rallies the team to your position.
Or R. So rally basically means come to me. Which I didn't know for a while. Alright, let's see what emails we have. Quite a few. Not surprising though. Special Ops from Stephen Hackett. Shepard, Alliance forces are stretched thin across the galaxy. We need your specific talents for a series of ops. These missions will open doors for the Alliance in places we can't touch through conventional means. We'll deploy operatives to hold point after you've completed your objectives. I need you to head to a Cerberus lab on the planet Sanctum. I'll brief you when you're inbound. Hackett. Reinstatement from Stephen Hackett. This letter formally acknowledges your reinstatement into the Alliance Navy per Admiral David Anderson's recent verbal communication. Under Emergency War Powers, Regulation 903.5, you are hereby authorized to assume command of the Normandy SR-2. You are directed to begin interdiction operations against any and all enemies posing a threat to Earth, its colonies, and its allies. Furthermore, you are granted diplomatic authority to establish treaties with non-human races as required to support your mission. Sincerely, Admiral Stephen Hackett. Emergency flash traffic urgent. From Alliance Fleet Operations. Flash, flash, flash. Lights out. Oh, that's another song. X1A.34. All Alliance military personnel. This is a galaxy-wide alert for all human territories. Fleet Admiral Hackett has declared threat condition Saber 1. Enemy presence confirmed in Sol System Earth under Reaper attack. All Alliance military personnel are directed to evacuate Sol System at first available opportunity. Do not attempt Earth approach. Heavy enemy resistance reported. Repeat, do not attempt Earth approach. Further instructions to follow on coded channel Crimson Tacit. Earth-based Alliance personnel unable to evacuate are directed to commence any and all necessary countermeasures. All remaining Alliance personnel outside Sol Theater are directed to muster at pre-appointed staging areas and commence offensive combat operations at first available opportunity. In absence of further instruction, independent action is authorized. KEA-9. Subject, my dog. Dear Commander Shepard, I was a contractor working on the Normandy's haptic interface when I was in dry dock. Your VI, Edie, again, publicly being a VI, emailed me to let me know I left my dog mech on board. I'm all the way out in Terra Nova now and would hate for you to go a million clicks out of your way to drop off my dog. Please just take care of her. She likes exploring, sniffing chemical trails and 750-volt outlets. Thank you and sorry for your trouble. I promise she won't be too much of a headache. Andrea Brown. She was a contractor. Okay, so somewhere there is a mechanical dog on the ship. Righto. N7 weaponry. From Lieutenant D. Eugene. Commander Shepard, your VI Edie put in a request to me for a handful of N7 grade weapons. Happy to oblige. I led the engineers who retrofitted the Normandy when it was turned over to the Alliance. Edie kept me company when we were overhauling the Normandy's interior. She's a beautiful ship, Commander. I'll miss working on her. I left the guns in your weapons locker. Best of luck, Lieutenant D. Eugene, Alliance Engineering Corp. Sounds familiar. Lieutenant Eugene. ANN Alert. New article, Quarian Fleet. From Alliance News Network Information Partners by Ruxius Rilius and contributor. Citadel, where is the Quarian fleet? The latest intelligence shows that the Reapers are taking system after system at a feverish pace. Members of all races are fleeing their stations, colonies, and in some cases, their homeworlds. This kind of forced exodus might seem especially familiar to the nomadic Quarians, who were pushed off their homeworld by the synthetic Geth centuries ago. But as the galaxy pushes back against the Reapers, the Quarians are conspicuously absent. Turian and Alliance spokespeople cannot provide the fleet's current location. They say they have other concerns at the moment. Yep. Whatever the Quarians are up to, they want it kept secret from the Council. After a refueling stop at Ilium, the fleet left no stated destination. There are also reports of a galaxy-wide call for all young adult Quarians to abandon their pilgrimages to rejoin the fleet. Greedy and short-sighted powers will always try to gain the upper hand in times of a galactic crisis. We can only hope that whatever the Quarians are planning does not interfere with the only thing that should matter, stopping the Reapers. Read Ruxius Rilius's regular column, View of the Empire, exclusively on ANN. It was like CNN. Welcome back, gift. From Edie. While we were in dry dock, Joker suggested that a small welcoming gift would be appropriate to have on hand should you be reinstated as commanding officer. As the ship does not have the capacity to accommodate the dancers he suggested, I chose something from the Official Systems Alliance catalog. Soldiers who have held an N7 designation for 5 years or more are entitled to a commemorative hooded jacket for wear on off-duty hours. You will find it among the selection of casual clothing in your cabin, Edie. The dancers. Okay, so we have a mech dog and a hoodie. You have an upgrade waiting. From Glyph? That was Glyph. Dear Commander Shepard, some of the data you found allowed me to research an upgrade for you. Simply access the terminal in Dr. Tassoni's office at your convenience and you may choose how and when to implement it. Have a pleasant day, Glyph. Priority mission, Eden Prime. From Alliance Command. Alliance Command. Commander, Cerberus has attacked Eden Prime and is now occupying the colony. Huh. They have. Alliance forces are stretched too thin right now to attempt to liberate the colony, but we've been doing what we can to covertly aid the local resistance. Excuse me. In the process, we've learned that Cerberus has uncovered a major Prothean artifact. We don't know what it is, but appears to be the reason for the attack on the colony. We need you to infiltrate the colony and recover the artifact. So now we're back on the other side of Cerberus, as in the first game. Only now, Cerberus is more of a threat. Right, so we've got all kinds of updates and stuff, and we've got boxes and things like that. We need to fill these chairs. We need all the help we can get. Who are you? I can't actually talk to you. The hell is up with that? Now I guess it's just so he can salute me. It's awfully unusual, though.